3, the King of the Moondoggers, and welcome again to another of your favorite blues, rhythm, and jazz rock and roll parties.
Disc jockey Alan Freed is considered by many to be the creator of the term rock and roll. He was also the promoter of the Moondog Coronation Ball, considered to be the first rock concert of record, and ended with the police shutting it down. But he didn't have an easy time of it with many people trying to prevent rock and roll from being played on the radio, but thank goodness they didn't prevail.
My reasons on rock and roll music and why I preach against it, and I believe with all of my heart that it is a contributing factor to our juvenile delinquency of today. Why I believe that is because I know how it feels when you sing it. I know what it does to you. And I know the evil feeling that you feel when you sing it.
Rock and roll has got to go.
In 1985, Ahmet Ertegun, co-founder of Atlantic Records, was the brainchild behind the creation of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. They broke ground for the Hall of Fame on June 7, 1993, and the hall opened September 1, 1995, with a blockbuster concert at the Cleveland Municipal Stadium the following evening that lasted for 6 hours and 40 minutes, ending at 2:10 in the morning. The show opened with Chuck Berry and Bruce Springsteen singing Johnny Be Good to a crowd of 57,000 fans. Upon entering the Hall of Fame, you are greeted by a friendly staff who will process your tickets and direct you to where to go next. Most will head to the lower floor where the main gallery is. This is where you can spend several hours reading and viewing the history of rock and roll. It starts with the early influences of rock and roll, like blues, gospel, country, folk, bluegrass, rhythm and blues. Many names you have probably heard of, whether we know their music or not. There's a section that features the major cities that have had an impact on rock and roll, like Memphis, Detroit, San Francisco, Seattle, New York, London, and don't forget Liverpool, home of the Beatles. And then there are the stars, like Elvis, the Rolling Stones, Jimi Hendrix, the Beatles, take the escalator up a few floors, you're greeted with Pink Floyd's stage set from Another Brick in the Wall. It's pretty cool. Then, there is what they call the Artist Garage, where anyone can pick up an instrument and jam with other aspiring artists. On that same floor, you can see the current artists who have been nominated to be inducted into the Hall of Fame. Next to it is an area that lists all of those who have become members over the previous years. One of the areas I found interesting was on the 7th floor. It featured a few artists that had a technical influence on rock and roll, like John Cipollina from Quicksilver Messenger Service, who created a stack of speakers, horns, and other instruments that he controlled from a board of switches and toggles at his feet, and probably the better known Eddie Van Halen, who not only developed switches, toggles, guitars, and more to create his own unique sounds. If you ever happen to be in or around Cleveland, Ohio, check out the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. It's a pretty cool museum, and it will certainly bring back lots of memories. Rock and roll, my friends, is here to stay.